Hey, it's Jang here with the new buildable LEGO Kylo Ren from Star Wars The Force Awakens. And while the LEGO minifigure version of Kylo Ren with the hood down was kind of comic relief, he's really funny looking, this big buildable figure, by comparison, is pretty serious looking. The helmet has a satin finish, not completely matte, but not glossy either. And it has a surprising number of very small little silver paint applications on the top of the helm and also around the nose bridge area to indicate wear. They also have very fine detailing of just subtle things that don't stand out all that much, such as around the mouth, you know, the small holes. They're very finely molded. The edges are very crisp on this thing, on the prints and the molds. They've even got the dents that are actually molded in there. That's not just the look of a print. It's actually shaped in there. It's very, very authentic in that way. The lightsaber design in-universe is controversial, but LEGO did a good job of building it this time around, I think much better than they did with the minifig version again. They actually introduce a new piece right here, which attaches to the hilt, and you just have an axle that goes through there, and then these are three long minifigure-sized lightsaber blades, so the shorter versions of those. So you do fully build the thing up, all three blades. The main body piece is not a new or exclusive mold, but it does have its exclusive print, of course, which has a good pattern on it and a little bit of detail down around the belt. But I really feel like the cloth pieces are what do it for me for this set. I've got that really good shaping around the shoulders that kind of accentuates them farther than they should be for the build of the actor. And then down here, this angle right here, I think works really well, and they've still got the slat down the center to allow this to flow. And it's got a nice weight to it. You know, it always wants to kind of fall straight down, so that just kind of adds to the quality and believability. The figure also has an action feature built in with a geared mechanism for the arm. You turn a knob on the back and the arm just goes straight up and straight down. It has enough friction in it to allow you to just let it go and it won't fall on its own. So you can still pose it like a static figure however you want to, just on display or just for holding it yourself. But you've got that option there, and it's not too stiff, so it's not difficult. See, I can just do this with a single hand. Don't even need to hold on to the figure itself. So a good compromise there with the friction and posability. With the cloak and head removed, check out this build from the back. It actually follows around with good coverage here, so there's no major open space, which is surprising given that the cloak covers up everything anyway, so I think that's even more than they needed to do. And then this is a new piece, this whole housing up here on the top, which includes a ball end for attaching any kind of socket joint, including what they put at the base of the head. But all of this is new because the torso piece that they use under there, which you're not going to be able to see easily, actually has no ball connection at the top, and it has no shoulder. So it brings in the hips and a little bit of the vertical part of the body. But beyond that, it just terminates with just technic connection. So this is an entirely new style of build for the torso, and going in a direction that I did not expect. I thought that with this whole system, this character and creature building system, or CCBS, that LEGO has been doing for a number of years now, that they would add more different styles of bones and different styles of armor, kind of add-on pieces. But this is fundamentally different and changing the way that things are built. And now down below, and with the arms as well, the build is much more traditional and standard here, and just uses the same sort of design that they did for the first Star Wars buildable action figures from this series, with the large spike pieces for the calves. Overall, joint articulation for this figure is good, although I admittedly don't yet know many iconic Kylo Ren poses to try to replicate. But there is one thing that's a little bit messed up here. It's the left to right turning of the neck. It is limited in how far you can go, and that's because of a little ridge on the back of that new upper body piece that I showed. Not a bad model, although it kind of gets into a bit of an uncanny valley effect for me, where the realism of the head and also the cloth pieces are kind of contrasted against the plastic, you know, more generic design, obvious buildable design of the arms and the legs and such. But this does seem to be a pretty good action figure, and it also looks pretty respectable just on display. Share your thoughts about the set if you'd like to by leaving a comment on the video, and I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks for watching.